Hello students, welcome to SUFFA e-class. In the previous lecture, we have discussed one example which is given in your textbook. In that, Mahendra and Virat are sitting 1 meter apart from each other. Their masses are 75 kg and 80 kg respectively, and we have to find the gravitational force between them. So we have used the formula which we have learned in the previous lecture, that the gravitational force is given by F is equal to G multiplied by M1 multiplied by M2 divided by R square. And in that we have substituted the value of masses and the distance. After that, the gravitational force will be calculated between the Mahendra and Virat is 4.002 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 7 Newton. And we have seen that this value is very, very small. If the bench is frictionless on which Mahendra is sitting, then Mahendra will move towards the Virat under the action of this gravitational force. And now we can calculate the velocity and acceleration for this condition by Newton's equation of motion and Newton's laws of motion. Now today here, one question, one example is given to us. In the above example, that is in example number 1, which I have shown you here, assuming that the bench on which Mahendra is sitting is frictionless, means Mahendra is sitting on that bench and then that bench is frictionless. Starting with zero velocity, what will be Mahendra's velocity of motion towards Virat after 1 second? Will this velocity change with time? How? So student, we have to calculate the velocity. For that, we will consider what is given to us. So according to the example number 1, the force between Mahendra and Virat, that is F, is equal to 4.002 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 7 Newton. So we have calculated this value in the previous lecture. The force on Mahendra, this is nothing but the force on Mahendra. The force on Mahendra F is equal to, that is 4.002 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 7 Newton. So student, here Mahendra's mass is equal to, that is M, it will be equal to 75 kilogram. Mass of Mahendra is 75 kilogram. This is given to us in equation in example number 1. Now we have to calculate the acceleration produced by the force on Mahendra. So student, for calculating the acceleration, we have to consider the Newton's second law of motion. And we know that Newton's second law of motion is nothing but, it is the formula for force. According to that law, force is equal to mass into acceleration. So here we can consider, according to Newton's second law of motion. So according to Newton's second law of motion, force is equal to mass into acceleration. Now we have to find the acceleration here. So A will be equal to, this M will go to this side, it will be F by M. Now student, by this formula, we can find the acceleration produced here when Mahendra will move. According to this, the formula for that force is mass into acceleration. We have to find the acceleration, that is the acceleration is equal to F by M. So student, here we can calculate is equal to force. The value of force is 4.002 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 7 upon, this is M, this is mass. Mass is nothing but it is the mass of Mahendra, that is 75. If we will calculate this, student, let us calculate this. If we will calculate this, you have to solve it in your notebook. If we will calculate this, then the value will be is equal to 5.34 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 9. And this is acceleration. What is the unit of acceleration? We have seen in the 9th standard. Yes, it is meter per second square. So student, this is nothing but the acceleration produced when Mahendra will move according to this gravitational force. So student, this is the acceleration. So A is equal to 5.34 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 9 meter per second square. Using the Newton's first equation of motion, we can calculate the velocity of Mahendra after 1 second. So student, let us consider the Newton's first equation of motion. We have discussed the Newton's first equation of motion in the 9th standard. So using Newton's first equation of motion, that is v is equal to u plus at. We know the Newton's equation of motion. The first equation is v is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, and the last equation is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. So this we have seen in the 9th standard. So according to Newton's first equation of motion, we can calculate the velocity, that is v is equal to u plus at. This is the formula for velocity. Now here at initial level, Mahindra is sitting on a bench. So initial velocity of Mahindra is nothing but zero. The initial velocity of Mahindra is zero. So as Mahindra is sitting on a bench, initial velocity u is equal to 0. So we have to assume u is equal to 0. U is nothing but initial velocity here, and as Mahindra is sitting on a bench here, the initial velocity will be 0. So if the bench is frictionless, so assuming the bench is frictionless, assuming that the bench is frictionless, we have to calculate the velocity. So for that we will put the values. The velocity is given by v is equal to u. Here we have considered u as 0. Here u is 0. So v is equal to u 0 plus a. What is the value of a here? 5.34 multiplied by 10 is to power minus 9. And here now it is t is nothing but the time, and time is given to us, that is 1 second. So here we'll multiply it by 1. So v is equal to 0 plus 5.34 multiplied by 10 raised to power 9 multiplied by 1. That is nothing but 5.34 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 9. So v will be equal to 5.34 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 9. And this is velocity, and the unit of velocity is meter per second. So here we are considering the unit of velocity, that is meter per second, which we have discussed many times in the 9th standard. So student, this is nothing but Mahindra's velocity after 1 second. So we can say that Mahindra's velocity after 1 second will be 5.34 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 9 meter per second. So student, this value is very very small. This is an extremely small value of the velocity. The velocity, now we have to see that what will be the Mahindra's velocity. So we have seen that what is the Mahindra's velocity towards Virat after 1 second. Will this velocity change with time? So we have to give the answer of this question. Will this velocity change with time? So the velocity will increase with time because of acceleration. Why? Because the acceleration will also not remain constant. Because of Mahindra move, as Mahindra move towards the Virat, the distance between them will decrease. And if the distance will decrease, the gravitational force will increase. And if gravitational force will increase, that will increase the acceleration also, as per the Newton's second law of motion. So student, you have seen that if Mahindra will move towards the Virat, then the distance between Mahindra and Virat, that is the value of R, will decrease here. And if the value of R will decrease, the force, the gravitational force between them will increase. By decrease the value of R, we have seen that the gravitational force is depending upon the distance inversely. So that is why we have seen in the formula for gravitational force that the gravitational force is inversely proportional to the square of distance between the two bodies. So as if the Mahindra will move towards the Virat, the distance between that two bodies will decrease. So if the distance will decrease, the force will increase, and increase in force increases the acceleration. And if acceleration will increase, no doubt it will make the change. If the acceleration will increase, it will increase the velocity with time. And this is nothing but the solution of that question which is given in your textbook. You have to note this solution in your notebook. Now if this question may be asked in the examination, you have to solve it properly by using this formula. So student, the formulas given here are Newton's second law of motion. The formula which we used is force is equal to mass into acceleration, Newton's first equation of motion. You have to go through the textbook of 9th standard in order to get this formula. Just revise it and try to solve this question by yourself. So this is all about the today's lecture. We will move towards the next question or next topic in the next lecture. Thank you.